live from the studios of Channel 9, entertainment capital of the universe. Welcome back to the show that refuses to die. And now, here's the star of the show, Summer!
Hi, it's me, Septic Tang. Welcome back to the clan. Hey, man. And so today we'll be playing Unearthing Mars 2, The Ancient War by Wanker Games. Today I'm going to be playing Unearthing Mars 2, The Ancient War by Winking Skywalker Entertainment. Very exciting. So here is the footage. I hope you guys enjoy this. Ready? In Unearthing Mars 2, the extracted Phobos fragments from Mars are analyzed through the ARC device and leads players to embark on a journey to unravel secrets of the ancient Mars civilization, torn by ongoing war. So as you can see here, there are many cutscenes, which I like a lot, and also there are many. Each of the various fast-paced shooter stages features six or more weapons to choose from. The primary weapons are an assault rifle, shotgun. As you advance further into the levels, you can unlock special weapons such as rocket launcher, plasma weapons, chain guns. Additional rare and powerful weapons can also be found during the boss fights. So yeah, guys, I really enjoy the footage here too. The head tracking, it allowed for a perfect tracking in the beginning of the game. As you saw, it has like great tracking. But, from beginning to end, it does seem to have the capacity and the ability to slow down time, as you can see, and trick shot them, kind of like in Red Dead Redemption. Red Dead Redemption 2, Shawshank, I'm sure that's what it's called. This game is having an amazing experience on my body. I felt amazing sensations, actually, I gotta say. The hairs stood up on the back of my bum, and I felt really alive in this game, even though I died a lot. It's very hard, actually, but you don't die much if you're real good, like me, and I only died once. But in this whole time I played, I really enjoyed the slow motion ability, super fantastic time. It does have quick turning, but I barely noticed it. Also, the movement scheme is on rails in a sense, but you're able to actually move around depending on where you want to go and if you're allowed to go there or not, which most likely 80% of the time you're allowed to go there if you wanna, but not too close. Sometimes you're prevented from going really close to the wall, which is fantastic, because who wants to go into the wall? Also, there are many boss fights, many different weapons. I was very surprised, and surplus was high this year. I was very surprised, and there was no real letdowns other than the anti-analyzing in the background. Had a long time analyzing. It was like it was anti-analyzing. I don't know, it was just a little bit blurry in the background, but the rest of the game was great. The graphics were AAA in my opinion. The look of the gun and the feel of the environment, I think, was 10 spot 10, which is actually more of a 7.7 out of 10. It wasn't bad, guys. Bah! Boss fights, though. I'll show some of that at the end of the video. I don't want to give away too much of the game, but I will show you one boss fight or two. And as you can see, the weapons are on fire. I'm having a fang. I'm having a blast. It's so fun, guys. You can see that thing on the left, top left of the screen? That's my little robot body. Simply by pressing triangle, it will pop out and it will attack the bullets coming at you. And if you don't have that out quick enough, you can dodge the bullets, actually, if you want to know. And I had a great time dodging bullets. It felt a lot like Super Hot in that way. I enjoyed that. As you can see, the movement scheme is a teleport system, which I didn't mind at all. And boss fights have, obviously, as most games would have, a weak spot, which I appreciate in this game. However, when I went to fight the boss, I couldn't find it. Maybe I was confused. It was meant to be in the arm, but I couldn't see it. But nonetheless, I still kicked its butt.
Where are the others? Are they dead?
I don't know. After he and his team had decided to split up, they had lost all communication with White Gun, and they didn't meet up until it was all over.
So in the USA, this game cost about $17 USD, $17.99, and in Australia it's about $24, $25, which I think is totally worth it, and I highly recommend this title. It's actually really good. Here's some of the boss battle right here that I mentioned before. Look at this thing. I'm shooting it, do you know what I mean? It has like some sort of rail system, like I said earlier, but I really do appreciate the way it worked. It actually added to the game. Instead of getting lost like I usually do in most games, this game kept me focused on the goal. It kept me focused on where I needed to go next, constantly, therefore never getting lost, which I really appreciated the pacing of this game in that way. Sometimes the enemies were repeating a lot, like I would fight the same ones over and over again, but still, guys, so far I fucking recommend it. The cutscenes are marvellous, they look like movie scripted scenes. I really, really appreciated the intro, actually. This is the intro here. There was just a bit of a moment here where I was a little confused about the relationship between Shepard and myself, or me and the guy, that guy. Because when I started playing the game, I didn't know if I was a female character, because we're holding hands! And it made me very uncomfortable, but I'll get over it, it's 2018. But you know what, guys? I'm still very confused about the relationship, because it turns out I'm a dude! So I guess we're just real good buddies. I mean, I guess I hold hands with a buddy if I'm scared in space. I guess I'd hold Lewis's hand, maybe. Or Mr. Boring's hand in space, I guess I'd hold it. I'd hold it if they asked me to. I mean, if I didn't have a choice, if it was the only way to survive, I'd hold it. Thanks for watching, guys. Please hit the like button and subscribe.